Hello friends, welcome back to our class on RBI and its monetary policy. And this is the second module, and in this module we will concentrate on the RBI's function as the Central Bank of India. Okay, so as the Central Bank of India, RBI performs numerous functions. We are identifying one after another. Okay, so we have arranged the 9 functions in accordance with their importance. The most important function of the RBI, you know, it's monetary policy implementation, rather formulation and implementation. That is a prime function of the central bank, and it is a regulator of the banking system, not just a regulator but also a supervisor of the financial system, including commercial banks. And the RBI is the banker to the banks. Okay, and now, like banker to the bank, RBI is also banker and debt manager to governments. Remember, both the central government as well as the state government. Okay, the center and the states. Okay, now the fifth function is that the management of foreign national reserves and foreign exchange management. Okay, so this is an extra function regarding the external sector, you know. And the sixth function is the oversight of the payment and settlement system, here RTGS, NEFT. Okay, and the seventh function is the currency management. This was the original function assigned to central bank when they were born around 350 years back, you know. And it regulates the note issue and it controls its circulation as well. And the next one is development function. The RBI promotes several institutions, including institutions like the National Payment Corporation of India, then Deposit Insurance Corporation, etc. You may heard about such institutions. So RBI has created such institutions in the past, and even now it is continuing such efforts. And the last one is an important one. Okay, so it is providing research and statistics. These are the functions of the RBI. We have identified 9 functions. We have arranged in terms of their importance. The most important one, we can easily mention that it is formulation and implementation of monetary policy. And we are coming to the first function. As you have mentioned, it is the most important function. Okay, and this is the prime function of any central bank. The central banks are known for monetary policy design and implementation. And the second one is financial regulation and supervision. You have seen during the last module how important is that function. And here regulation means regulation of the money market. Which institutions or which entities the RBI really regulate? It regulate the short-term money market. Okay, money you can get, no, you can, but financial institutions can get for a short period, like 1 day up to 14 days, like that, you know. So such short-term money markets are there. One is the call money market, where banks can borrow money from 1 day to 14 days. Okay, so that is called call money market. So that is the money, could the call money market, you can say it is some sort of a liquidity market. Okay, you can get what there, you can get liquidity from the call money market. Another liquidity market is the collateral borrowing and lending obligation market. We are not right now concentrating on these two aspects, you know. We will concentrate only, we'll cover those issues only in the later classes. So regulation of the money market, and similarly regulation of the foreign exchange market. Okay, so FEMA, Foreign Exchange Management Act, is under the control of the RBI. So foreign exchange management is, and as well as the management of the foreign exchange, okay, market, it comes under the RBI's control. And again, next is the government securities market. The RBI also regulates as well as supervises the government security market. And the market for certain type of financial derivatives like currency derivative, interest rate derivative, so such regulation comes under RBI, not with the SEBI. And regarding the government securities market, you know, that is very important, especially from the prelims point of view. The government securities, like, you know, the treasury bills, or we can say the government bonds, which are otherwise called as what, dated securities. Okay, otherwise they are called as data securities. So their yield, okay, their yield, etc., are of importance nowadays. So we have to understand such things. We will come into the various issues and dimensions of government securities market later. The RBI itself facilitates government to borrow from the domestic market. So RBI itself has an e-cuber platform for the auction of the government securities market. So similarly, there is a negotiated dealing system. So all such facilitations are made by his central bank regarding the promotion and the regulation of the government securities market. And next one is, you know, regulation of the banking and non-banking financial institutions. This particular function, regulation of the banking sector, we are much familiar about that, you know, because whenever a bank is under stress or it is facing some sort of a crisis, you know, it is the RBI which comes into the forefront to fight for that bank, as well as to ensure the security as well as the safety of that particular institution. So financial regulation, especially regarding the banking sector and that of the non-banking institutions, okay, so they are under the functionality of the RBI. So we can get all those things from the current issues themselves, you know. And next function of the RBI is that it is the banker to the banks. You have seen the historical evolution of this function. RBI act as the banker to the commercial banks and to some of the financial institutions like RRBs. RRBs are always, you know, regional rural banks. Okay, they are sponsored by commercial banks. They are scheduled commercial banks themselves, you know. So RRBs are one type of scheduled commercial banks, sponsored by commercial banks. So RRBs, local area banks, they are non-scheduled commercial banks. Okay, and state cooperative banks, all these institutions are regulated and supervised by the RBI. So RBI gives what, banker to bank function to all these institutions. Okay, banker to bank function. And the next function is that RBI is the banker and debt manager to governments. Remember, governments, not just the center but also the states. That's very important. Banker to the governments. Okay, banker to the governments. The RBI undertakes debt and cash management for central and state government. So since the central government is one of the biggest financial entity in India, its expenditure is big, its tax revenue is also big, is bigger than many of the financial, many of the corporate entities in India. So its impact is also huge. So the government gets a lot of tax revenue. It has several expenditure commitments. Revenue comes tomorrow, expenditure has to be made today. So there will be a gap. And whenever the gap is there, the RBI will be giving money to the central government as well as to the state government. Okay, so RBI indulges in cash management of the central and state government. Okay, cash management means the RBI keeps custody of the cash, of the cash balances of the central government, as well as whenever the central government, as well as the state, you know, when they need money, the RBI gives quick money or quick funds to the governments in the form of facilities known as ways and means advances, you know, then overdraft. Okay, so such facilities are provided by the RBI for the central and state governments. We will see about such facilities provided by the RBI in a later module. Okay, and similarly, RBI is also the debt manager of the government of India as well as the state government. On behalf of the governments, you know, RBI issues government securities like treasury bills. Okay, remember, treasury bills, state government doesn't have treasury bills, government bonds. Okay, bonds means what we can say, it is not just bond, we can say that dated securities. Okay, similarly, in the case of state government, state development loans. Okay, they are securities issued by securities of the state government issued by the RBI. Okay, so that state government can mobilize funds from the market. So the debt management and cash management for the central government and state governments comes under the functionality of the RBI. Okay, RBI is the banker and debt manager to the governments. And next, management of foreign exchange reserves and foreign exchange management. Here, you know that this is an external sector related function of the RBI. RBI manages India's foreign exchange reserve. The value should be stable. The country should not lose any value out of its foreign exchange reserve. You know that the foreign exchange reserve of India is at present, it is around $469 billion. Okay, so the responsibility of the RBI here is to keep the value of the foreign exchange reserve intact, as well as to invest it in good and quality assets. Okay, and here foreign exchange reserves are precious, valuable and strategic assets. That's a cover up against any currency crisis or currency risk. So that is the significance of foreign exchange reserve. And here, you know, the RBI's responsibility, it is a custodian of foreign exchange reserve. Okay, it is kept in different form, including foreign currency assets. And here you have to understand one thing. RBI's function is not to, what we can say, manage the foreign exchange rate. The RBI is indirectly intervening in the foreign exchange market. But the management of the foreign exchange rate is not the direct function or responsibility of the RBI. Indirectly, it may be influencing, or what we can say, it may be cutting out the extreme volatility or fluctuation in the foreign exchange market or value of rupee, you know. So the main function of the RBI regarding the foreign exchange sector or foreign exchange reserve, you know, is management of foreign exchange reserve. Okay. Next is oversight of the payment and settlement system. Okay. Here you know that the payment and settlement system is an important network for the banking system. Okay. Payment between banks, it's settlements. So that is very important to facilitate transaction, money transaction between banks. So it is the responsibility of the RBI to create and to promote payment and settlement system. And here there's the development of payment infrastructure by the RBI. Like, you know, there is the RTGS. You heard about RTGS, real-time gross settlement. Similarly, there is the NEFT, National Electronic Fund Transfer. Okay. And similarly, there is an institution called the National Payment Corporation of India Limited. Okay. National Payment Corporation of India Limited. Okay. And similarly, there are a lot of payment instruments, prepaid payment instruments, which are promoted by NBCL. Okay. So this is an important function of the RBI, promotion of the settlement and payment system. And the next function, the function for which we always remember the central banks, we always admire the central banks, is regulation of note issue and its circulation. Okay. RBI is the issuer of the currencies. And the next function is development function. A set of development functions are provided by the RBI. Creation and development of institutions and infrastructure. For example, Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation is one institution. Clearing Corporation, another institution. Like the NBCEL. Okay. NBCEL is another institution. All these institutions are created by RBI for the promotion of monetary and financial transaction. So RBI has tremendous development functions in the economy. So we have mentioned about National Payment Corporation of India. This is just one example. And the next function and the last function that we are coming to see is research and statistics. And if you are analyzing the research activities of different central banks, including US Federal Reserve, European Central Bank, the Australian Reserve Bank, the Bank of England, you know, of all central banks compared to other central banks, you know, the RBI has a tremendous research facility as well as research output. Okay, it makes research on various aspects of the domain, including monetary policy, banking, exchange rate, etc. And it has large number of publications like Financial Stability Report, Monetary Policy Report, etc. Report on Trends and Progress of Banking in India. So we will see the various research activities of RBI in the coming session. Okay. Now we are going to see the performance of RBI as a developing economy central bank. Okay. In the case of advanced countries, bulk of its tax is to maintain price stability. For a central bank operating in an advanced country like the United States, the most important responsibility of the central banks is to ensure what? Price stability. Okay. But in its developing economy, you know, it may have different functions, including to promote economic growth, okay, to ensure financial stability, etc. In developing countries, okay, including India, besides ensuring price stability, okay, that is a core function, and financial stability, we can say it is the second most important function. Central bank have to do other functions, including supporting economic growth. Okay, so growth promotion is one function. It is a difficult function for a central bank because there is a conflict between economic growth and price stability. The central banks are created for promoting that prime function of ensuring price stability. So when it is going to promote support economic growth, there will be a lot of problems and it has to compromise the prime function. And another accessory function of central bank is to create financial infrastructure and institution. We saw that. So for example, we have seen the NBCL, National Payment Corporation of India Limited. So besides the traditional functionalities assigned to the central banks in the developed countries. There are other functions for the central banks in a developing country like India.